Sports and Music Festival. Austin has been invaded by inline skaters, and I think some of them are nude.
Hey guys, Peter King here, hanging out on the street course, getting ready for inline skate. Crowd is psyched, am I right? Okay, I want you guys to know that I'm here with longtime legendary inline pro Pat Parnell.
Thank you, Peter.
Tell us about some of the legends we got here today beside yourself.
We've got literally almost every continent represented. We got guys from Japan, actually girls from Japan. We got
guys and girls.
Guys and girls competing, showing a little girl power here. Sayaki Yabe, she's from Japan. Even a guy down from Ensenada, Mexico. You probably surfed down there at San Miguel. Marco Hintze.
Yeah, cool. All right, not bad at all. So we got 10 of the best. You just heard about a couple of them. First rider up, Dion Antony. Tell me about Dion.
The mystical Dion Antony. This guy's big Doors fan and just a powerful skater. You're going to see how much speed he brings into the course. Known for his Royales, kind of a good style and a kind of almost like a set slide. We call it a shuffle in inline skating. And just an all-around awesome guy. Very like into meditation and nature.
All right, Dion.
Skating for BSP.
Go
all
off,
good people.
Dude.
Go big, Dion.
Get into it, crowd. You know he's going to show you something right now over the forest. Can you say wall ride? Not as speed from this hip, Pat.
Ah, oh, he is on fire this run. That's called a Farfugnugan once again. You gotta, it's actually difficult to keep
track. If you're constipated, is it called Farfugnugan?
Farfugnugan.
A 360, oh, a little wheelie there. Popping wheelie like a jerky boy on that one.
Well, one of our obstacles we put out there is the cameraman, so this guy's gotta go around the cameras.
Oh, nice. So all the way down the ledge. Awesome run so far for Dion Antony. Bringing incredible speed. A solid topsoil. Is that soul grind, PK?
He's got a lot of soul because he's listening to San Diego boys, Pennywise. He knew he had soul.
Tell me about that run, dude. It was sick.
Let's check it on the monitor here. Check out the speed he brings into this.
Far from pooping.
Far from pooping, actually. Far from pooping. It's like a reverse Royale, but it's actually called a Farfugnugan.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Okay, rider number two. Like a new kid on the scene or something, like a beginner, Arlo Eisenberg.
A virtual unknown. He's actually a local Texan, and according to Newsweek, he's the one to watch at the turn of the century or into the turn of the century.
I'm not the best athlete in rollerblading. I'm not the best skater in rollerblading. And the reason I've gotten to where I am and why I am valuable to rollerblading is because I bring more than just skating talent.
Yeah,
he's the one to watch right now. There's your music, Arlo. Show us what you know. Jermon's going big right off the bat.
Big mute air gap down in the bank. Nice smooth transfer over that hip. Arlo's got incredibly comfortable style, especially in the air.
Arlo's just cruising through the street forest of bat brains right now. I think that says anything about his mental state.
He's got good taste in music.
Arlo's not scared, is he?
Ow.
20 seconds left, gang. Cheer him on. You know he's going to go big.
A little 540 over the fountain there.
540 off of that little bump. That's mad. Time for one more, Arlo. Sick run, Arlo. Give me a hand, people. And work your way on back, too. What'd you think of your run? Pretty sick? Fun?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Check out over here, we got a replay of it. Right. What are we gonna see? Is that 540?
Yeah.
No, why? How'd you do that?
That's one of those old standby tricks. At the end of the run, you're tired, have nothing to do, just like, throw it out there.
It's like the ace up the sleeve.
All right, cool. Who's next up? We've got Marco.
Tell
us about Marco.
Marco is a new guy that's exploded on the scene. He just tied for first at our championships last week. He's a hot skater, one to watch.
Well, that's what we're going to do right now. Marco, you ready? Hands up.
You're like winded.
Good run, Arlo. Thanks, man. Let's go. Get him going, crowd. Marco Hintze, recent winner.
Check out this wall ride, Peter. He's huge. Wide. Comes off at fakie.
Over the awning. Is that a fakie 720?
Fakie 720 off that little quarter pipe. Check out this transfer to rail. Frontside grind down the rail, Peter.
Marco's ruling.
This guy's from Ensenada, Mexico.
Crowd, feel free to not stop cheering because everything he's doing is good now.
We got the groove cam. Check out Sean Tomlin in the groove cam. He's like getting a little POV there.
No setup tricks in this run at all. It's all straight moves.
There's 540 up the bank there.
10 seconds left.
Big old slash chance down that planter.
That's it, Marco. Good run.
Cops are coming in. Somebody called the cops.
Big finish right there.
It's a great run for Marco Hintze.
Dude, that was a sick run. All mad moves. No setups. Check out this replay. What do we got here? Is that fakie 720?
540.
He's thinking high about that thing, too. Thinking about Lucky Charms.
He brought it around there, so that's why I give you 720 when he straightened back out. Who's up next? We got Chiaki. Tell me about Chiaki.
Oh man, Chiaki, that guy, never stops laughing. Just check him out, big ass smile. He's so cool and he does insane tricks. He can do whatever he wants.
Chiaki Ito is from Japan and I think we say go fight. It's called, we say combate. Here he goes.
Combate, Chiaki! Skating to 311. Off that huge gap, getting inspired by the song Criminal because that's what just about everyone at this music fest is as far as security guards are concerned.
A little chin check on the ground there.
I think he tried to do that though, yeah. So I give him props. I don't even know what props are, but I'm giving him. I just heard that word for the first time.
Ali and Misa again. Topside.
Huge over the hip. Yeah, Chiaki, give it up, people!
He's having a sick run here, Peter. Zero spin, the half cap, named after Steve Caballero there. Yeah.
All right, Chiaki, come here. What about that run, man? It's pretty sick.
Yeah, okay. Here comes Chiaki. It was an awesome run.
That was good. Yeah. Anyway, Chiaki. Sports and music. International language. Music, you like?
Yes.
Sports, you like?
Hi. Say yes.
Hi. Chiaki, it's psycho.
Arigato. Thank you very much.
Check this out. Check out this fall here.
Chiaki-san, ripping.
Check out this transfer. And check out, he goes down hard. Yeah.
What's that, Chiaki?
Give me my 40.
All right, Chiaki wants a 40.
Check this out right here.
He's gonna. He wants to tip it to his memory. That was insane, Chiaki. You want a 40, 41, whatever it takes?
Hi.
Arigato, Chiaki-san. Ichiban, ripping.
All right.
Okay, Ben Jagger. You know, your friend?
Yes, Ben Jagger. Nice.
Okay.
Nice, that's right.
Ben Jagger, nice.
Thanks, Chiaki.
Ben Jagger, nice. Get ready, boy. Ben's sick, dude. English guy.
I don't know if he's Tory or Whig, Party, but
describe why he did that to me. What's going on in his mental psyche to do a big fat 360 over the gap?
Oh! It's the old wall ride, mono style, coming off fakie.
Oh, sick. This is a big run. Dude, he looks pumped. See, this is one of the runs the guys do in practice where they hit everything and they go, dude. You just gotta pretend you're not in the competition and just rip.
And that's a porn star going down that ledge. Liu Kang, little Hong Kong fooey when they kick the leg out like
he's
that.
He's ripping to the descendants. He's the one.
Come on, you guys, put your hands together for Ben Jagger. Throw a little noise into the street course. He's a tour.
That run was sick, dude. That was like a practice run because he made everything.
All the technical grinds, big airs over the box, and that huge solo wall ride.
We are sweltering in the sun here at the street course, folks. And we've just seen five incredible rides by the inliners just going off, using the whole course, going huge. And we actually got some highlights, don't we, Pat?
That was Dion Antony.
That's the forest jump. I love that.
It's like the quick click. That's Marco Hintze. There's Chiaki, buddy from Japan. Ben Jagger, and off of that huge 360 over the gap.
Chiaki wants his 40, and Ben wants his crumpets. We got some more hot action coming up, first I want to send you guys backstage to Carson, who's hanging out with my friends from San Diego, Blink 182.
What do you guys think about, like, the skateboarders, the BMX bikers, the inline skating, while you guys are playing? This is a cool mix down here.
It's the best thing, and we're really involved with the Warped Tour, and we grew up in San Diego, so it's very common to us to be tied in with all the sports and stuff.
You guys skate a lot down there?
Oh, yeah.
All the time.
We're Steve Caballero, what up?
He's our boy. He's a legend.
Right on, we've got more Blink 182. They'll be back on the main stage in just a little bit here at the Sports and Music Festival.
MTV 500.
I'll tell you what, man, those dudes are like creeps. I'll tell you what, they put the aggressive inline skating. Hey, you know, you need to get the gigging information right on ASA, the Aggressive, you know, Skaters Association. They're huge. Here's what you do. You call NLA 310-399-3436. It's gonna cost you. But screw that, it's worth it. So let's check out something else. I got an idea. Let's go get a little more torqueage, rippage, tanking, like flipping out, people losing it. I say we go get a little Southern Cali dip of the Blink 182, baby.
The song is Damn It, Bloody Damn It.
Hey, y'all, my name's Peter King, and I'm hanging out with veteran inline pro skater Pat Parnell. Say hi to the kids, Pat. Give it up for Pat. Now, Pat, you've been skating a long time, so you're up to speed. But the rest of us, we may not be. So let's check out the history of inline skating in this piece right here.
The first aggressive video, this still was before it was aggressive skating, was Dare to Air. This was the video for these kids that they first saw. This was their introduction to the sport. We actually literally made this video in our living room. We basically took a little 8mm camera that you could buy at the store and a VCR, and I sat there and hit pause, record. I think it embodied the whole sport. I mean, the ability to roll and just cruise through the city and find all these different aspects of the architecture and the landscape to take. It was almost like having your own skate park all to yourself. I'd say Dare to Air kind of got the ball rolling, but the hoax was really the first modern aggressive skate video.
And it basically became kind of a Bible for the sport.
When I talked to Arlo back then, he's like, "This, we gotta document this, we gotta make this film," and he pushed me to do it.
We had an opportunity to document something from the very infancy of it and actually influence it in a positive way. I think videos are the single most motivating factor in the growth of aggressive inline skating. Kids watch videos and they learn from videos. If videos had never been released in aggressive inline skating, I don't think the sport would have taken off.
Well, I must say, that was pretty impressive, Pat. It seems like this sport has grown a lot in a short time. What do you think?
Put me on the spot. It's actually, it's pretty amazing the growth it's had in the past 3 years. It still has a lot of growing to do, but these guys are just doing incredibly technical stuff nowadays.
So what do you mean it's got growing to do? What's going to happen? What's in the future for inlining? Like younger kids coming up? I mean, I see a lot of young kids and girls that are insane. I mean, is it just whoever goes after it or what? I mean, what's the deal?
Well, definitely it's going to be a guy-girl thing, but it's all about the AMs right now, and the sport's going incredibly technical. It's in the next 5 to 10 years, it's going to grow immensely. You know, if you look at skateboarding and the other sports, they've been around for a long time, so it's going to be exciting to see what inline does in the next couple of years.
Cool. Well, we got the second half of the inline coming up right here on MTV's Street Course at the Sports and Music Festival, so stick around.
I just am like convinced that those dudes, like those inline dudes, the inline skate dudes, they're like, they're madness, they're sickness, they're looniness. You gotta like stick around and do the gig with us and, you know, check it out, find out what's like ripping with these dudes. These freaks, hey, look, they might lose an eye or something, and that'd be unfortunate.
Tonight at 7:30 on the Week in Rock, it had...
Sports will buy your old sports equipment from you.
Isn't there, like, some kind of ordinance against this inline street stuff?
Hey, everybody, welcome back. Peter King sweating in the midday sun with Pat Parnell, professional inline skater legend. We've already seen some incredible rides, five so far.
That's right.
It's pretty insane. Let's check some of these out. We got some highlights, the first five runs. Walk us through this stuff.
That's a cartoon character. We got Dion, Antony. And check this out, Arlo, almost doing a long jump over the box here.
But he went through the trees.
Yeah. That was a groove cam on that one.
Sick.
There's your buddy, Chiaki.
Chiaki-san, looking for his 40.
Awesome stuff. It's been a wicked morning.
That's good, huh?
Really good vibe, good session here so far.
You guys like the course, you think?
Oh, dude, love it. Yeah, it's a little different, like I said, but it kind of forces them to like get a new perspective on everything.
Change
stuff.
Is good.
Yeah, change.
No sweat.
Change
okay,
is cool.
We got our sixth rider, John Julio.
Yeah.
San Jose boy.
Innovator.
Getting go big,
Cal.
John. Gonna have a good run. Give it up John. For him, people. John Julio, come on. How's that? That's pretty huge for first move. He wanted the whole
thing. I want that whole ledge. John's style is so smooth and quiet. Awesome breakdancer, too.
What?
Going for a fish brain stall, an inverted fish brain stall.
But that was a belly. That was insane, dude.
It's called
that
a gut.
That's called a suntan jump. You don't even know what you're talking about.
A gut buster.
Don't hit that car. We don't want to hurt that car. 20 seconds, John. Building up speed for something near that rail.
Oh, transfer off the hip to the soul grind.
5 seconds left, Johnny. Time for one move. Let's see him heading for the hip as the siren sounds.
Let's check out his run here. Kind of Luke Kane's actually kind of launches off that soul grind. Check this out. Check out the little hip.
Okay, next up, our seventh rider, Josh Petty.
Yeah, the man with no belt. That's right, Josh Petty.
Because I'm just somebody that really likes to skate and hang out, and yeah, that's about it. That's all I do is skate and hang out.
Oh, it's a little kid
saying his thanks.
But he's gonna go about twice my height, so let's dig it. Skating to Wu-Tang Clan. Go ahead, Josh.
Looks like he's gonna kick ass. Huge torque grind, get on one foot.
Whoop.
Yo.
Yeah.
Oh, Luke Kane 180 coming down on the tranny.
That was insane. He's going big and he's hitting everything.
Disaster to backside grind.
Yeah, he's making everything, people. It's a clean run. Give it up, people. 10 seconds, Josh.
10 more seconds for Josh Petty.
Don't worry about pulling those pants up, babe.
Oh, and goes for a
540 to Steve Porter. Off of the truck.
Wicked run from Josh Petty.
Okay, let's watch this.
Such smooth style. Look at that.
Okay, next up, we have Salima.
Salima comes all the way from Lausanne, Switzerland. So she's our next skater.
Which is odd because she's French.
That's right.
But, you know.
And she's got curly hair.
Give it up. Give it up, people. She doesn't need a helmet. She's got one.
If you like afros, put your hands together.
Give it up, people.
That's right. I'm trying to get in the groove here. Oh, smooth transfer. Look at that shuffle.
We're all just trying to stay alive here.
Little, little booty bump there.
80 Town USA fountain, 80 Town USA saw jump. Gotta do that double.
Little zero spin over the grass.
Back, give it up. 10-second step. Groove cam's following all the action.
He is literally tying her heels. Little acid drop over those stairs, Peter.
You just jump those stairs. You're supposed to walk downstairs. I think I hear a police siren.
Salima.
It's a good run, dude.
She's
kick alley-oop.
She's cute to boot, and she skates.
She's sexy and strong. She's a double threat, this girl.
Okay, right.
Tell us about Randy, man. He's getting ready to rock.
Despite the fact he's only been skating for 3 years, this guy has influenced a lot of skaters out there. He's got a go-big style and just an awesome attitude about the sport. But he's pretty good.
Okay, go get him, Randy. Show off. Kick. Cheer him on, gang.
Big, big, big zero spin. An interesting choice,
Randy's
the Spice Girls.
Skate to my favorite band. He just loves those cheeky Spice Girls, and he's pretty cheeky himself.
Fancy footwork up there.
Pat, I say on a scale of 1 to 10, sassy.
Randy's just has an awesome attitude, go fun spirit. Frontside Unity, it's crossing up the legs, kind of Indian style.
That was massive control right there.
He just came off a big win in Florida, won the ASA World Championships.
Groove cam's following the last move here.
Big 540 acid there, Peter.
Insane. Good run, Randy.
Hey, Randy.
What can I say? Just
any run to the Spice Girls is okay by me.
Okay, the last competitor of our event.
Yeah, it's been an awesome day. And she is from Japan, as I pointed out. And she's one of the two girls here representing.
Let's give her a big Texas welcome. That's Sayaki.
I love that transfer.
Groove camera hot on her tail. She's trying to get away from him.
It's a game of cat and mouse.
Ah, she eluded him. She hit the rail. Going up that loading dock, the rail.
Oh, smooth Royale. Frontside Royale, PK.
Yeah, that's what a handrail's for. Put your hands on it and pull yourself up.
Oh! Goes for that huge gap over those bushes. Kill it.
Dude, that was a sick run. She was fully going for it. She smooshed me a lot. Hey, guys, we just saw riders 6 through 10. Crowd is psyched, Pat. Everyone did a great job. Let's check out some of the highlights here, Pat. Walk us through some of this amazing action that went down.
Break it down.
The event was cool, right? I mean, we tried not to be too geeky and nerdy with it, right?
We did our best. Ben Jagger, 360 for the gap. And Josh Petty. There's Salima. Uh-huh.
Hubba hubba.
And little Spice Girl himself, Randy Spizer.
Randy, hubba hubba.
Wow.
Good stuff.
Sick.
Good stuff.
Okay, well, it's time to vote, and what's unique about our competition element that we brought in is there's not really judges. All the riders are going to judge amongst themselves.
No rinky-dink judges. We bring in the kingpins of the industry, the riders themselves.
Nope, so we're...
Right now, they've...
It doesn't really matter what you and I think, is what you're saying, right? It's not up to us.
Absolutely.
Okay, so the riders are going to judge themselves, but we need to find out what the crowd thinks. And Carson's over there with the crowd. What's the vibe like in the crowd, Carson?
The vibe is very hot, Peter. You guys all right? Seen some great events. This is my friend Tony here. He's an inline skater from Houston. What do you think about the event so far?
I think it's great. I mean, all the skaters are ripping it up, and they're just going off today.
All right, Peter, let's see what the voting turns out to be. Back to you.
We've got player representative Arlo Eisenberg. Vote and come on down, Arlo.
Right.
You've got the magical results in there, and I just think it's amazing that we saw everything, the riders riding to the Spice Girls, to Wu-Tang Clan, That just sums up the international crowd we have here today.
Let me get a little sneak peek on that.
Pato, don't try and look.
It's Wu-Tang Clan, Peter. This is the stuff that dreams are made of. Last night, Josh Petty got to hang out on the stage with the Wu-Tang Clan. Got to meet all the guys.
I think you know who the winner is.
Champion of Street. First ever, 1997 MTV.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Josh.
Oh, yeah.
Can't define it, I'll be dropping these mockeries. Wu-Tang Clan. Josh, take the microphone, talk to the kids.
This contest was the best of the year. Plus, by far.
Last night you got to meet the Wu-Tang Clan. You got to hang out not just backstage, but on the stage. And today you're the champion.
Go, guys, that Josh Petty won. Crowd, give it up for him! He's your winner! His boys are stoked! Take it away, Carson!
That was a rad event. Stick around, we've got more Blink-182 coming up, and skateboarders get vertical. Stick around.